Have you ever wanted to try a tiling window manager, but then you realize that installing Arch Linux or setting up something like Hyperland is just way too much work? Well, in this video, I'm going to show you how to turn your KDE desktop into a tiling manager. It's a really nice way to try it out because you get that tiling feel without having to give up your easy-to-use desktop. So, let's get started! First, open your application menu, search for KWin scripts, and open it up. This will take you right into the system settings. Now, click the Get New button and wait a second for it to load. We're looking for a script called Cronkite. If you don't see it right away, just use the search bar to find it and then hit Install. Once it's done, you can close that window. You'll see Cronkite added to your list. Just check the box next to it and hit Apply. Now, try opening a few windows to see if it's working. Don't worry if it feels a little laggy or weird at first. That's normal. Usually, a quick logout and log back in fixes everything and makes it run smoothly. You'll notice right now that it doesn't look great yet because the windows are touching or overlapping. There aren't any gaps. So, let's fix that. Go back to the KWin script menu and click that little gear icon for Cronkite to open its configuration window. Inside the Cronkite settings, you'll see a lot of options, but we only need to change a few. Go to the Geometry tab. Here, you can add gaps around your windows. You'll see 5 options. 4 are for the edges of your screen, and the middle one is for the space between the windows. I'm going to set mine to 8 pixels for each, but you can pick whatever looks good to you. Once you're done, just hit Apply. Now that we added the gaps, you might notice that the window title bars are taking up a lot of space. It kind of ruins the look and makes everything feel cramped. Let's get rid of those. Once you are inside that Cronkite settings, head over to the Options tab. Look for the box that says Remove Border of Tiled Windows and check it. And don't forget to click Apply. Now, it probably won't change right away. As you can see, the gaps haven't appeared yet and the title bars are still there. So, you'll need to log out and log back in. Once you do that, everything will refresh and your desktop should be looking clean and tiled. So, I'm back after logging out, but as you can see, the title bars are still there and there is no gaps in between. If this happens to you, don't worry. Just go back into KWin settings, uncheck Cronkite, hit Apply, and then check it again. The moment you hit Apply the second time, it should trigger the changes. There we go. Now it looks exactly how it's supposed to. Let's open a few more apps and see how it looks. Perfect. Now we've got that nice space between the windows and the title bars are gone. Now, if you usually rely on those 3 buttons to close, maximize, or minimize your windows, you might be wondering, what do I do now? Since those buttons are gone, we're going to use keyboard shortcuts instead. Go to System Settings, Keyboard, then Shortcuts, and look for Window Management. You'll see a massive list here, but don't worry, you don't need to remember all of them. Let's just focus on the few you actually need. The first one is for closing a window, which is Alt plus F4. You might already know this one, but if not, here's how it works. Just click on the window you want to close and press Alt plus F4 and it's gone. Next, scroll down that shortcut list until you see the shortcuts for Cronkite. You'll see a ton of options here, but don't let that overwhelm you. Let's just look at the ones you'll actually use every day. The most important shortcuts are for focusing on your windows. For example, right here you can see Focus Down is set to Meta plus J, and Focus Left is set to Meta plus H. Now, let me show you how these actually work in practice. To test this out, make sure you have at least 3 windows open. Right now, I'm working in this window on the right side of my screen. If I want to switch to the window on the left, I just press Meta plus H, and just like that, the focus moves over. As you can see, the window is now highlighted, even though I didn't move my cursor at all. Now, you might be thinking, why bother with shortcuts when you can just click on the window? And you're right, you can definitely still use your mouse. But the whole idea behind a tiling manager is to keep your hands on the keyboard so you can work faster. Personally, I still like using my mouse for a lot of things. But having these shortcuts ready makes everything feel much smoother once you get used to them. The next one is really important, and that's the shortcut for maximizing your windows. On my setup, I have this set to Meta plus Page Up. Let's see how it works. If I'm browsing in Firefox and I want it to take up the whole screen, I just hit that shortcut and it fills the display. If I press the same shortcut again, it snaps right back to its original tiled position. It's a super quick way to focus on one thing and then go right back to your layout. So now we are done with the shortcuts. Next, we will modify the panel to match our window tiling setup. First, I'm going to move the panel to the top. Just open its configuration window and set the position to the top. Next, we're going to move these icons to the center. To do that, open the widgets panel, find the separator, and drag it onto the panel. Now you can move your group of icons to the center, right in between the separators. Next, we're going to add some widgets to get back the information we're missing since we removed the window title bars. Open the widgets panel and search for window title fork. You probably won't have this in your list yet, so click the Get New button and download it from the Plasma Store. Once it's installed, just add it to your panel. The next widget we need is the Global Menu. Drag that one onto the panel right after the window title. Now you can close the widgets panel and exit edit mode. Let's open an app to see how it looks. I'll open Dolphin here. As you can see, we're now getting the title of the active window and its menus right in the panel. If I switch to a different window, the title and menus change to match that app instantly. So now, we aren't missing anything. We have our titles and our menus, and for closing or maximizing windows, we can just use our shortcuts. After adding those widgets, you'll notice that when you are on your empty desktop, the title bar shows the word default here. It doesn't look very good, so let's change that. Right-click on the widget and select Configure. Check the box for Customizing Default Text, and then you can type in your name or any custom text you want. Next, you'll see an option to show the title in a bold font. I personally don't think it looks great here, so I'm going to uncheck it to keep it looking clean. We're also going to change the default icon. First, enable the icon toggle, and then check the box for placeholder icon. Once you do that, the option to change the icon will be highlighted. You can choose whatever you prefer here. I'm going to go with this cute little emoji. After you've made your changes, don't forget to click Apply. Now, when we look at the desktop, you can see that both the default text and the icon have been updated. Looking at the top panel, it felt a bit too thick, so I'm lowering the height slightly. Now the whole setup looks much cleaner and more compact. Our tiling manager is set up, but it feels a bit static. Let's add some animations to bring the desktop to life. In your system settings, search for Desktop Effects. Inside that Effect Settings window, click the Get New button and look for an effect called Geometry Change. When you find it, hit Install. If you see multiple versions, simply choose the one with the highest version number. Once the installation finishes, make sure the effect is enabled. It might activate automatically, but if not, check the box and hit Apply. To get the most out of this effect, we need to tweak the speed. Click the gear icon next to the effect to open the configuration. By default, the duration is set to 250 milliseconds, which can feel a bit too fast to notice. Increasing this to 400 or 500 milliseconds gives the windows a much more fluid motion. Once you've adjusted that, click Apply and watch how the windows animate when they resize. As you can see, the effect isn't triggering yet. If you run into this, there are two quick solutions to try. First, simply disable the effect and re-enable it. This usually forces the system to recognize the new settings. And now, as you can see, the animations are working perfectly for me. We finally have those fluid animations. If the movement feels a bit slow for your taste, you can always go back into the geometry effect settings and dial the duration down until it feels right. These fluid animations also works when moving windows around. And if you notice my windows shaking a little, that's the wobbly windows effect. To get this same look, just search for wobbly windows in your desktop effect setting and toggle it on. Lastly, if you feel the standard KDE application menu doesn't quite fit this tiling setup, you can simply remove it and use KRunner to find and launch your programs. That covers everything for this guide. Thanks for watching. If you're new to KDE and want a full customization walkthrough, check out the video on the screen. Feel free to subscribe for more content like this in the future.